What?
Haru.
Oh, wow. Spots him. That was a heads up wall of pain. As hits the first three. First four.
Oh,
now standing on top of Haru. Has to flash to get away from the power of the Karthus.
Really good wall of pain into follow up Lay Wastes. And that's going to set Haru back massively in terms of tempo. He's even smiting
the lanes. Mystic lands the Q. Vista in a whole host of trouble. One auto would have been necessary.Has Mystic down to about 200. Lahan's now in trouble as well, but he's able to just...
One of the things also going on here, he's going to recall into Runic Echoes that he's going to be able to pull clear his jungle. Sally negligible, although it will protect against Requiem almost entirely.
That's a good point.
Goldwater Cutlass picked up.
Well, there's the ulti to come down from Mystic. Calibrum damage in there. That's how you get a kill. You just say, send in the Karthus, and he'll pick that one up.
For the Afrika team composition, and Lahan looks like he's panicking.
Yeah, we're looking for a hard engage now as Vista pulls back the feathers, but it's not going to land on a Mystic. Infernum has been brought out as Spirit. Going to come on over. Temp, Lay Waste, going to miss, but he's got the heal. Takes a turret shot. It's not what you want, but the stun is just off cooldown, and Keen isn't coming down. Spirit flashes for it. Now waiting for that wall of pain, but honestly, he doesn't need it because Fly has the stun.
The benefit is Spirit looks like he's about to take that Karthus up to the top lane, plant down the Herald, and this is really good. When you have Karthus on your team, he has conditions that he wants to be met. Trade with your opponent, get them low, so that the Requiem is adding the extra damage.
Oh, I think no reference.
Oh, okay, 9,000. Over 9,000, got it. Well, Cube can
that
get
is,
Requiem.
Yeah, they can't.
Those of you playing Karthus in solo queue, good idea, is the bubble is going to land onto the Karthus. He's
they
out of vision, but lands, picks him off. Now they're diving on in, but Spirit is still alive. Lahan surviving on just a sliver. No Requiem available as Cube was trying to get in with the Sky Strike on the outside, but he's not quite able to. Oh my god, reads it. It's now Mystic with the follow-up damage. Gets the snare from his Gravidim.
Palpatine up there.
Yeah. Overseeing yeah. his minions. There's the dive forward. Haro looking for Mystic, standing outside the fender. No, just caught on the edge.
And some of the remaining turret plates in mid lane, you don't want to get 15 plated. This
order.
Game as Haru, he's able to make this gamble knowing that even if him and Vista take some damage, Requiem's still on cooldown. And so...
I want to know exactly what's going on. Jelly trying to tank this one up as Mystic shows he's doing damage to it. Fly hasn't dropped his shield just yet as Lahan's going to pop before anything happens. Requiem comes down as well on top of Fly coming in.
Look
at
that damage.
Time. The moonfall's gigantic as Mystic looking for Cube finds the high... range at least, but Cube gonna have to run the heck out of there. Fly in trouble. Does he actually have any of that?
Way too far away. And it's not like Zoe has her regular flash and that there's a smite that she could pick up to try to go for some sort of a steal using her R or even her flash. And let's take a look at how this all transpires. Jelly missing a lot of his HP, 4,000 left on the Baron. Lahan pulls the trigger and goes for the backline. I don't know what he's thinking to try to do. Requiem comes out. And interestingly enough, if there's a point where Morello could maybe play a part, it would be here, but you can just see no one has any time to heal.
No.
As they're all running for the hills. And you saw that Requiem damage on all of the target.
Haru looking for a flank, but is that the flank that he wants? The Moonfall comes down. That is the Gravidim, so that means Cube is going to be stunned. And then the Dredge Line, the Depth Charge, everything comes forward, but Cube survives for a long time. Zaya picks up the kill onto the Karthus, and now the Requiem is going to come in. Jelly's dead, but Cube able to tank through that one. The Lay Waste almost taking out Haru.
All the magic resistances. So, take a look at it one more time. Mystic lands a really good ultimate on Aphelios, roots Cube down. Placing Maelstrom comes in the exhaust, but then Lahan just on the horizon. Comes in, locks everyone up. The Requiem ends up being cast, but not quite.
And showing the power of Zoe. at around the 20 to 40 minute mark.
Okay.
Requiem comes in. It's going to get a very early Featherstorm out of Vista and now will not have that available for the ensuing fight. As now Kyubey thinking about a flank, he gets slowed down, massive burst damage as that one comes in and Spirit flashes over the wall. Now it's a flanking Karthus scenario as Haru flashes and just misses the cocoon and goes straight to the death chamber. Tempt off to the side, Wall of Pain tags him up, and Efreaker aren't even interested in this dragon. They're just wanting to try and hunt down the members of Harm Alive that are still standing. The bottom lane are here. Maybe Jelly in trouble as Lehens with the quickness is going to run really quickly. But is he heading to the grave or to success? Dredgeline max range. It's all about success here. He may be going to the grave as well, but a double kill for Keen ensues. The dragon is taken down in about a
can do.
And what they should be doing is the main thing. Because that we've seen a lot of, especially Korean Karthus,
and they try to gank with them too much.
Exactly. And Spirit is just he's just living his best life.
Requieming.
Wait for the one that hits. There we go. Ouch.
Karthus is actually Thanos, you know? Dread
it. And he actually looks a bit like him as well. So look at that.
Just
avoids it and just dead. Extremely dead.
And Tempt trying to get away there at the very end. The remaining members ended up being dogged down shortly thereafter. And Jelly with the Nautilus hook from downtown.
Yeah, wait for this one.
Yeah.
And threads
I thought
the
that
needle.
Was going to hit Rakan.
Yeah, me too.
I've seen some of those Nautilus hitbox videos. And I mean, there was a chance it would hit the golems. On
Keen as well, running back the cannon. The last one was not great, but now he's getting enclosed. He goes the quickness. Grand Entrance comes down as well. The Trouble Bubble. He buffers the Slashing Maelstrom. Can he actually go golden?
Whoa!
I don't know whether he has one. As there's the Requiem. Down comes Haru to explode in lands. Almost dies as well. I would have stayed up
what
in the sky a little bit longer, to be perfectly honest. I don't know whether he was going to be able to get through there. And Haru had his Zhonya's back up off of cooldown. I think maybe he thought that the channel got broken, but it doesn't.
This is the thing about Karthus 2. Is that there is no mage jungler that is going to out-damage him or offer the same level.
Oh my god, Mystic almost died there. The turret is going to be the one that actually does fall. Moonfall comes down, Lahan's in trouble, but no Calibrum to lock him down from range. Now the engage comes forward. Kyubey is going to fall down. Spirit goes gold at exactly the right time and survives. No Requiem available.
Very layered to be extremely obnoxious.
Yeah, it doesn't actually have a stopwatch or anything like that. We couldn't see that at that particular moment. Although I had just looked at his items.
Rakan, no flash, no wall. It's gonna be definitely going to be the fall. Also, great itemization out of fly. Pure defensive utility. Requiem coming in early.
Yeah, we're starting up the fight with Attempt taken almost down to death as Kyubey is an afterthought in the back line. The Moonlight Vigil does fly forward as Lehens tries to get the quickness onto a few members. So far, they're actually doing decently, but Mystic is still alive, flashing with the onslaught onto Tempt, who will come back, but only to his death as the Grand Skyfall comes in. And Fly, you can't block that one, mate. But he still will win the game. Efreaker, they come back from an awful game one. To win back-to-back games and lock down top spot alongside Gen G here in the LCK after week one.
And Spirit feeling extremely relieved, it seems, after that game. And I always like seeing this champion hit Summoner's Rift. Not every day
really?
I get to cast
him. Really? I think
we're
all surprised. I think we're all surprised about your feelings towards Karthus. I don't think any of us know how you feel.
In the West, he is so underappreciated, and it's so bizarre. So anytime he shows up here in the LCK, I always do want to spend a little bit more time to talk about him.